Millions of drivers across the world have now recognised the benefits of having a dashboard-mounted camera in their vehicle, and the numbers are only rising.
I think the dash cam's a good thing to have because it basically gives you that sort of protection. You need to be able to prove that you're the innocent driver.
It's something that freelance business manager Nick Hopkins knows all too well. Driving up to 50,000 miles a year, he was definitely wise to have one installed.
It was about 3 o'clock on Friday afternoon. It was busy, everybody was heading home for the weekend. Something didn't look right in front of me. It was just the car in front was just way too close. There was a car in the middle lane further ahead that looked like it was either highways maintenance or possibly police. I think the car in front of the Citroen saw it, thought it might be a police car, braked. She tries to move into the middle lane. There's a car there. She obviously reacts to that. She's in a bit of a panic. She overdoes the steering, then she fishtails, hits the central reservation in the crash barrier. Her engine had exploded. You can see in the footage the battery disappearing off onto the outside lane of the other carriageway. But her entire suspension, front suspension and wheel, flew up, bounced off the front of my car and under it, which lifted me up, and then I didn't have any braking. And I slid into her, and I really thought I was going to avoid her. There were two concerns going through my head at the time. First of all, what was behind me? And secondly, what's going to happen to her? You can see from the footage, there's Arctic trucks going flying past just as it happens. How she didn't end up being hit by anything else, I do not know. All of a sudden, the M4 grounds got a halt. I believe it was 12 miles of tailbacks. And when you listen to the traffic reports, you realise that's you. That's you at the front of that. That's caused all that. You kind of sit there with your head held going, I'm sorry. The only thing she said to me was, why did he brake? Why did he brake?
But she certainly said more to her insurers. Expecting a simple claim, Nick reported the incident from his point of view.
A couple of days later, I get a phone call from my insurance company going, we've got a problem in that your statement is being disputed by her insurance company. The other driver's insurance company felt that it's a rear-end shunt, and therefore 100% liability is with me. Fortunately, I was able to state that I had the dash cam footage. As soon as my insurance company saw the footage, they were 100%, yes, we'll fight this. So 12 months down the line, finally the other insurance company accepted 100% liability. The dash cam saved possibly a £40,000 insurance claim against me that I would have to declare for the next 6 years. The £200 it costs, definitely worth its weight in gold.
So a momentary lapse in concentration costs this driver a lot more than just a no-claims bonus. Nick didn't rear-end her, but he did get a happy ending. One of the biggest causes of accidents across the world is driver distraction. In America alone, at any given moment, approximately 660,000 drivers are using cell phones or electronic devices while driving.
Staying focused when driving is crucial. We're not very good at concentrating as a species. We can do about 20 minutes of really intense concentration and then we lose it. Long journeys, motorways, dual carriageways, couple of hours on the road, our concentration will go in peaks and troughs, and it is really important that when you need to be thinking about your surroundings that you are thinking about your surroundings.
Sorry Ian, I drifted off. The number one deadliest driver distraction, accounting for 62% of incidents, is simply being lost in thought. So not noticing that the lights have changed. Or that the car in front of you has stopped. Or that there's a juggernaut in your side view mirror. But there can be serious consequences for distracted drivers. This pedestrian crosses when he shouldn't, but not only is the driver not concentrating, he's speeding too. Doesn't realise what he's done until after it's happened. Thankfully, the pedestrian survived, but the distracted driver still hasn't been caught. Another main offender is the mobile phone. 5 seconds is the average time your eyes are off the road while texting. This one's going for a new record. And travelling at 55 miles an hour, that's enough time to cover the length of a football field.
Put down the phone, put down the phone.
But our record break is still going. That's a total of 36 seconds, meaning she's travelled the length of 14 Olympic swimming pools with her eyes off the road. And there's plenty more out there like her. Those who drive and use a mobile phone are 4 times more likely to be involved in a crash. This couple in the black Range Rover are lost and are so distracted trying to find their way, they forget to check their mirrors before turning. Whoops! Distraction comes in all shapes and sizes, and you'd be amazed what people would do behind the wheel of a car.
Yeah, he's still on his book. He's got a book on the steering wheel. Male white, wearing a short sleeve t-shirt, left-hand drive.
Crazy bookworm. This fella's reading a map.
He's reading a bloody map.
And incredibly, watching a film.
Watching a film.
This movie buff was caught driving for 15 minutes at speeds of up to 50 miles an hour, watching his phone the entire time. When giving your friends a lift, remember, even they can turn against you and cause a significant distraction, like this poor girl found out. Whatever form it takes, distraction is everywhere. Oh, look, a sheep.